Hi viewers, welcome to Ultra Healthcare Tutorials. Today's video is about aerosols. So in this video, we will learn about aerosols, their advantages and components which are used to formulate aerosols. So aerosols is defined as a dispersed phase system in which solid particles or liquid droplets act as dispersed phase, whereas gas act as a continuous phase. So in this system is basically depends on the power of compressed gas and liquefied gas to expel the medicament from the container. Classification of aerosols. They are classified into three types. First one is space spray, second one is surface coat, and the third one is foams. So this space spray, it is a liquid dispersed into the air in the form of tiny droplets, and size of these tiny droplets are 50 micrometer. So the second one is surface coat. So surface coat after spray produces wet coat, and it's having particle size 200 micrometer. And this foam, it is a mass bubble formed into the liquid. Advantages of aerosols are, a dose can be removed without contamination of materials, and medicament can be delivered directly into the affected area. So target delivery is possible in case of aerosols, and irritation produced by the mechanical application of topical medicament can be reduced or eliminated by using aerosols. Rapid response of the medicament through aerosols, and they also bypass first pass effect as drug is going directly into the affected area. And sterility can be maintained, ease of convenience. So these all are the advantages of aerosols. Components of aerosols. First one is propellant, container, valve, actuator, product concentrate. So these all are the components of aerosols which are used to formulate aerosols. First one is propellant. So this propellant is responsible for developing proper pressure within the container, and it also provides driving force to expel the medicament from the container. And there are two types of propellants, and the first one is liquefied gas propellant and the second one is compressed gas propellants. So liquefied propellants, in this case gases exist as liquid under pressure, and as the aerosol is under pressure propellant, so it will exist mainly as a liquid, but it will also be in the headspace as a gas. So in this way, the presence pressure in the can will remain essentially constant, and spray performance can be maintained throughout the life. Second one is compressed gas propellant. Compressed gas propellant occupy head space above the liquid in the can, and it works when aerosol valve is open and gas pushes out the liquid from the container. So for example, carbon dioxide, nitrogen gas or nitrous oxide can be used as a compressed gas. Second one is containers. So containers which are used for aerosols must be stand at pressure as high as 140 to 180 psig, that is pounds per square inch gauze, at 1300 degrees. And the types of containers are metal containers. Metal containers includes tin plated steel, and this tin plated steel, it consists of a sheet of steel plate, and this sheet is coated with tin by electrolytic process. And this aluminium, this type of containers are used for inhalation for topical use. And this stainless steel containers, they are preferred in case of inhalation. So these are the containers which includes under metal containers. So the second one is glass containers, and these glass containers are used because of their aesthetic value. And in under glass containers, uncoated glass and plastic coated glass comes. Uncoated glass, they have less cost and have high clarity. From this container, content can be visible. And in plastic coated containers, these are protected by the plastic coating that prevents the glass from shattering in the event of breakage. So these all are the containers which are used in the aerosols. So the next one is valves. So valves, they are designed to deliver a drug in desired form and to give proper amount of medication. So two types of valves are there. First one is continuous spray valve, and the second one is metering valve. And this continuous spray valve, this is used for topical formulations, and this metering valve is used for dispense potent medication. So the components of valves are, first one is ferrule or mounting cap, valve body or housing, stem, gasket, spring, and dip tube. So this mounting cap, it is used to attach the valve to container. And this valve body or housing, it encloses stem or gasket and spring. And this valve body contains a opening at the point of attachment of dip tube. This stem controls the flow, and it is made up of nylon and stainless steel. And the next one is gasket, and this gasket, it is made up of guna and neoprene rubber. And the spring, it is made up of stainless steel, and it closes the valve. Dip tube, it is made up of polyethylene or polypropylene. So these all are the components of valve. So the next one is actuators. So these actuators are specially designed buttons which helps in delivering the drug in desired form, like spray, wet stream, or in foam, or in solid stream. So there are different types of actuators. First one is spray actuators. So these are used for topical preparations such as antiseptic, local anesthetics, and spray on bandages. And the second one is foam actuator. So this foam actuator, they are used for cosmetic preparations like shaving foams for shaving purpose. Third one is solid stream actuator, and this solid stream actuator are used to deliver semi-solid products such as ointment. So the fourth one is special actuators. So these actuators are those which are used for specific purpose, like to deliver medicament to the target site, such as throat, nose, dental, and eye. So these all are the components which are used for the preparation of aerosols. These are the different types of actuators: spray actuator, foam actuators. Manufacture of aerosols includes, first take empty can and then add product in it. After that, fit valve in it, and after valve, add propellant, and after that, fit actuator in it. So this is the whole manufacturing process of aerosol. And this is the filling equipment for aerosol, pressure filling equipment, and this is the pressure period which is used in the laboratories. And this is readily operated machine for aerosols, and it is used for the large production of aerosols. This is pressure burette for laboratory building of aerosols. And this is weight monitoring machine for aerosol. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any question related to this video or my previous video or any query, you can mail us at info@ultrahealthcare.in, or you can also visit our website, that is www.ultrahealthcare.com. Please like, share this video, and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you.